In today's video, we will share how to install solar panels on an RV roof. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell so you won't miss our videos. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and save it. If you have any questions or thoughts, leave a comment below and I will get you back. Let's get started. Mounting solar panels on your RV roof is a great way to keep your energy up and stay off-grid. This means you can spend more time traveling and less time needing to plug in at campsites. Hogan is easy for beginners and will show how to install solar panels on your RV. We will explain how off-grid system works, give you a step-by-step guide to putting solar panels on your RV roof, and tell you what mistakes to avoid. How off-grid RV system work. Off-grid solar system don't need electricity from local utilities like city power. Instead, they use solar panels, wind turbines, or water power to work on their own. Let's focus on solar power systems. Here are the parts of an off-grid solar system. Solar panels. These panels catch sunlight and turn it into energy. They feed photovoltaic batteries. These are special batteries that store the energy for when you need it later. Balance of solar system. These include all other parts like power controllers, inverters, wires, and safe devices like fuses and circuit breakers. Some of these parts might be built into other devices like inverters. How does the solar power system work? The solar panels catch sunlight and make electricity. The inverter changes electricity from DC to AC, which can power your appliance and gadget. This energy can also charge a portable power station. You can plug your devices into this station to use the storage energy. Install type. Mounting solar panels on your RV roof. You don't have to put solar panels on your RV roof, but doing so lets you gather energy while you are driving. Here are some ways to install solar panels on your RV. Fixed mounting. This method uses rigid solar panels. You will need to drill holes in your RV's roof and use brackets to keep the panels flat and secure. Flexible installation. Flexible solar panels can be bent to fit your RV's roof shape, making them easy to install. You will use tape to hold the panels in place. You might need to drill one hole in the roof to run the cable inside. Tilt mounting. With this option, you can tilt the solar panels instead of laying them flat. This lets you adjust the panel to catch the most sunlight, which helps create more power. How to mount RV roof flexible solar panels. Measure the RV roof. First, measure your RV roof, including everything already on it. You can use a computer program for the sketch app to draw the roof and place solar panels on it. This helps you to see how many solar panels will fit and where they should go. Be careful about where you put the panels. You don't want them near things like air conditioners because they can block the sun or part of the day. Next, put the solar panels on roof to see how they will look. Use colored tape to mark where each panel will go. Make sure they aren't placed where things like satellite dishes or air conditioner might shade them. Leave a little space, about 20 millimeters between each panel, if you are using more than one. This is important for setting them upright. Before you start installing, check the roof for any damage or leaks. If you find any problem, it's best to fix the roof first before putting on the panels. Verification of roof integrity. is your roof in good shape? Make sure to check every part of the area where you want to put the solar panels. Look for any tails, house cuts, or soft spots in the rubber roofing material. If you're finding any problem, please let me know. Once the solar panels are installed, you won't be able to reach the areas underneath them. Find your roof trusses. If your trail has roof trusses like mine, you need to find them to attach the zip rods. That is how I do it. Happy method. Tap on the roof with the flat head of a big screwdriver. Listen for places that sound hollow and the places that sound solid. This is a good way to find the trusses. Tap measure. My trusses are usually 16 inches apart, but sometimes they are not exactly at 16 inches, like when there's a wind in the way. Then, the trusses might be moved a few inches. Opening the ceiling, I open the wind mount from inside of the trailer. This lets me see the attic where I can spot the trusses around the wind. I can also use my tape measure from here to find the next truss. Using this method, you can figure out where the trusses are on your roof. Removal of obstacle. We suggest taking off any TV areas or satellite dishes from your cabin's roof. This can block the sun from hitting your solar panels fully. The best setup is to have only panels and wings on the roof so they can get the most sunlight. Propel the roof. If you need to clean and fix your roof, do it now. I patched some card with antenna state patches. I also took off the older ceilings at the back of the trailer and put a new one. It's hard to do things once the panels are up. Placement of panels on the roof. Once the panels are on the roof, be careful with the brackets because they might be sharp and could cut the roof material. Don't stretch panels across the roof. How you install the panels depends on the type you have. For rigid, you need to drill holes and screw them in. You can put them flat or tilt them. But you don't always need to drill holes for solar panels. Flexible solar panels can be struck right onto the roof with a strong drill. If you use rigid solar panels with fixed mounts, drill holes where the panels will go. Then attach the mounts to the roof and put the ceilings under the brackets to keep water out and bring wind leaks. Positioning panels using the marks you made on the roof. I use a permanent mark because it will be covered. Put the brackets where it needs to go. Just make sure it is the right spot. So if you need to, clean the area around the brackets before you start. Connect multiple solar panels. If you want to hook up more than one solar panel, you can connect them in two ways. Series or parallel. Series connect. Connect the position end of the first panel to negative end of the second panel. This makes the wall higher. Parallel connection. Connect all positive ends of the panels together and do the same with negative ends. This setup increases current if that's what you need. How to connect flexible solar panels? Parallel with Witcher series. Now that your solar panels are installed, it's time to connect them to your RV's solar system. There are three main ways to do this. Parallel, each panel connects separately to the charge controller. Series, all panels are connected in a line, then to the charge controller. Series parallel, a mix of both series and parallel. Panels are grouped together and each group connects to the charge controller. Each way of connecting panels has good and bad points. Please look closer at each one so you can choose the best setup for it. parallel to the panel wiring. When you connect the position and negative wires of each solar panel together, it's called parallel wiring. This way, each panel works on its own. If one panel is in the shade, the others can still work at full power. Connecting solar panels in parallel makes the current stronger, but keep the voltage the same. Because of this, you will need signal wires, as the synchronous depends on how much current there is. It's best not to connect more than 500 watts of solar panels in parallel, because you would need very thin and expensive wires to make it work well. Serial solar panel wiring. When you connect the positive wire of one solar panel to the negative wire of another, it's called a series connection. It's like making one big panel from several smaller ones. In series setup, if one panel is in the shade, it affects all other panels too. It's a downside of connecting solar panels in series. Connecting solar panels this way doubles the voltage in the wires, but keep the amperage the same. This lets you use signal and cheap wires because the current is low. However, the voltage is higher in series connection, so you will need a more expensive charge controller that can handle the higher voltage. So panel wiring in series and parallel. For big solar panel system like in Elvis, the best way to set them up is with both series and parallel connection, called the series parallel. This setup is really good for most RV solar systems. Imagine you have four panels. You connect them into two groups of two panels each. This way, if one group gets shade and stop working well, the other group can still work at full power. With the series parallel, you can double both the currents and the voltage. But do not quadruple it. This helps you use wires that are not too thin and a charge controller that isn't too big. We choose serial parallel connection because they offer a great mix of cost and system efficiency. The best flexible solar panels for RV. How do we pick the right flexible solar panels for car room? Flexible solar panels are great for campers because they are smaller and can be bent to fit the roof of your camper van. They don't need a lot of flat space. The SunGold 100 watt flexible solar panel is perfect for campers who don't have much room to install big panels. It's made to last a long time and has tough glass and special coating to protect it from bad weather, like heavy rain. Unlike the big strip panels that need a screw and brackets, flexible solar panels have small holes that you can hone it up or stick them to the roof with glue. These panels can be bent to match the shape of your cabin, so you can fit more on your roof. They also bend in well with your RV cabin. Plus, they are light, only 5 pounds, making them easy to move around. The SunGold 100 watt panel also came with a case and a cable that work with any solar system. You can use it to charge up a portable power station or a 48-volt system. Finally, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I will continue to share more content about solar panels. Now, I want to hear your thoughts. Do you have any more questions about installing solar panels on RVs? Besides the RV panels mentioned above, SunGold also offers other types of solar panels. Are you interested in learning more about them? Please tell me in the comments below. Let's charge!